it's finally happening. After all the challenges we've had this past year, finally have this day going the way we planned. And I can't wait for this, to be married, to start our lives together. Joana, I love you with all my heart, and we are gonna have a great life.
That you're here, I really am. I know we planned it for years. Okay, think of a joke. Cause I'm
you're crying. No, I'm crying.
No, I'm just really excited to be here with you guys. It's just been forever to plan this, but here we are. And I want to have. It's like a party. I know this is a wedding, but oh my God, don't cry.
I'm not crying.
No, I was honored when you told me.
You.
This has been great. Salud. Every single one of these ladies here is amazing, and I know that everybody loves you. So
I love you guys.
Cheers to you and Josh.
Hi babe, it's me, Joana, just in case you forgot. No, just kidding. I'm just really excited that we're here, we're doing this. It took forever to plan, but it's all worth it. I'm ready for forever. Love you, baby.
Tap him on the right shoulder, and he's going to turn to the right. So, just like we talked about in the morning.
Thank you. You guys can have a seat. Who gives this woman to be with this man? That's your part. There you go. Awesome. Here you go. Okay. You took a shower? That's great. All right. Well, I want you guys to do me a huge favor. I want you to take a deep breath in, okay? Not that breath, right? Yeah, way too soon. All right, but I want you to just look out into the crowd, all right? What's awesome is that you've got so many people who are here to support you and love you, and these are the people you get to lean on as you guys go through this this thing called marriage. So let me pray real quick. Father, I thank you so much for this time. Thank you so much for who you are and how you love us. God, I thank you so much for this family. Thank you so much for their love and for the fact that you knew this would happen before you ever gave us a breath to breathe. God, we want to glorify you through this ceremony. It's in Christ's name we pray. Amen. Amen. All right. All right, we're going to be done quick, okay? So don't worry about that, okay? So so normally I start with the bride, but I've known this kid ever since he was, and I call you a kid, but you're a 30-year-old kid, all right? One of my first memories when I was thinking about Josh is his dad teaching me and him karate in my parents' living room, all right? Which if you look at Luce, there's no way you would think that he knows karate, all right? But he did, all right? And I thought I was awesome, right? But what I do remember, though, was how much you adored your family. I remember the respect that you showed your family, the way you would look at your mom and the way you would look at your dad, and with the amount of respect that was incredible. And what's been interesting, as I've been able to reconnect with you and talk to you, is unreal the amount of respect you have for so many people. You're a man of honor, and what's interesting is you're a man who gives honor. And I can tell you this, that is a characteristic and an image of Christ. And I'm so proud of you, so proud of the man you are. Through all the battles that you've gone through over the last couple of months, you've been able to be steady and to keep moving forward. And so what I believe is this, is that all of that is getting thrown into, okay, baby. It looks like cake. All right. So, when you put that into this woman, what you're going to find is a woman who will love you dearly, who will respect you and encourage you and equip you. And why I know that is because just the few conversations we've had, what's funny is that you're fierce. I love it. Yeah. Rawr, kind of fierce, all right? Like, I love it. Not only that, you're really funny, too. It's like, and it's not like, hey, girl funny, but like real funny, okay? And what I found interesting is that the way you would talk about Josh and the kind of, and you guys have been together forever, all right? But the way you would almost swoon a little bit with him and when you were talking about him and why you love him and all those things, it was clear to me that you have a deep love for him and one that you would do anything for. And then shortly after that, he gets sick and you took care of everything. It was rough, but what was great was this, was you showed him exactly the kind of wife you will be, someone who will love him and take care of him. What I believe is this, scripture teaches us a couple of things, all right? And it teaches us, one, that when marriage comes, when it comes to marriage, it talks a lot about serving one another and trying to outserve one another. And what I've seen just through the conversations that we've had is that the two of you really enjoy serving each other. And that's something that a lot of couples start out with, but you guys have been together for so long. It's something I believe that's going to bleed through as we move forward. I'm going to just real quick charge to you guys, and then we'll get to the vows, okay? All right, so Ephesians 5 tells us this, all right? Ephesians 5 tells us, wives, submit to your own husbands as unto the Lord. Now, real quick, that would create some hairs on the back of people's necks. Submit? No way. All right? You can't submit. That, not in 2020. But here's the thing. When scripture was talking about submitting here, what it really ultimately is saying is respect your husband. Because Josh's number one desire in life is not to be loved, but it is to be respected. And I can tell you this, if you respect him, you will make him a better man. All right? Every man, when he feels respected, walks with a bigger chest.
I mean, yeah.
Yes. Yes, he has a big chest. All right? The other thing is this, is that when you respect him, what you're doing is going, I believe in you and I trust you. But it would be easy for us to do that, right? And just say, oh, well, she's supposed to respect. But you actually get a stronger commitment, all right, from Jesus. And it says this in verse 25. It says, husbands, love your wife as Christ loved the church. Now, here's the thing. How did Christ love the church? He willingly gave his life up for her, meaning this, that you are to love her as Jesus loves you. Meaning this, when Ephesians 5:1, the first verse in this chapter, says this, be imitators of Christ Jesus. What that means is every single day you wake up, Josh, and you go, I'm going to look as much like Jesus as I can today. And I'm going to tell you this, it's not only going to benefit you, because Jesus was about love, grace, forgiveness, service. There's not a single person in here would go, I don't think you should be those things. But it doesn't only impact you, it impacts her and it impacts him. And what we believe is this, is if you love her well, she will easily submit to you. Because when you love her well, what happens? She knows her needs are taken care of. Her desires are taken care of. And that you've put her before yourself. And ultimately, that's the definition of service, right? Now, I told you guys, all right, Ephesians 5:1 says, be imitators of Christ Jesus, right? Well, we believe this. In 1 John, it says that God is love, all right? And there's as you walk down, you walk past some verses. And you didn't know I was going to put this in your wedding. No, no way. All right. But in 1 Corinthians 13, it says this. Love is patient and kind. Love does not envy or boast. It is not arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice at wrongdoings, but rejoices with truth. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. Now, here's the thing. When we see the word love here, it would be really easy for us to go, well, that's just love. But actually, if we look at 1 John, it says that God is love. So what this really is a description of God's character. So love, if you replace it, is Jesus is patient and kind. He is not envy or boast. He is not arrogant or rude. I mean, those are things that we know of Jesus, right? But here's the better thing. Ephesians 5:1 says, be imitators of Christ Jesus, right? So in essence, this is a description to have a perfect marriage. Ask yourself this. Josh, are you patient or kind?
Patient.
Yeah, well, no, I'm not. These are not, these are rhetorical. All right. I don't need one of these. Yeah, I'm patient, kind. No, you're not. All right. But here's the thing. Ask yourself every single day. Am I being patient and kind? Is Joanne, does she envy or boast? Is she not arrogant? Is she rude? Does Josh, does he not insist on his own way? Is he not resentful? Do you guys rejoice in wrongdoing? Do you rejoice with the truth? Do you bear all things? Do you believe all things? Do you hope all things? Do you endure all things? I'm going to tell you guys endured a lot. But here's the thing. I believe this, and I truly believe this with all my heart. When we focus our hearts on Jesus, and we strive to look more like him each and every day, what happens is naturally, as you guys focus towards Christ, the two of you will naturally be drawn closer together. And we know this. Before the foundations of the earth, God knew that today would happen. Before he ever created air for us to breathe, or for trees to recycle that air, or for ground for us to stand on, he knew that this would happen, knowing that you two would fall in love, and he drew you guys together. And so if before the foundations of the earth, God would have us celebrate this, then in essence, love never fails, all right? Because he doesn't ever fail. And so I encourage you guys, strive after him. Look like him. Outserve each other. Outlove each other. Because ultimately, no one gets married just to get married. People get married because they want to have the best marriage possible. And I can tell you this, the best way to do that is to focus on Jesus and let him be the foundation of y'all's marriage. All right. You guys are doing your own vows, all right? Yeah. So, Josh, you get to go first because you're the man.
All right.
Yay. And he wrote them down.
I did write them down.
Sorry, I ran out of paper.
I was going to do that.
Why did you?
She's already correcting you. Yeah, I love it.
I'm used to it already. We're finally here. Joana, there's not enough words to describe the amazing person you are. You're a terrific mother, an even better partner. I find myself falling more in love with you every day, even to this day. I am very blessed to have you in my life. I promise to always stand by your side and to be your rock and to be with you for through everything life gives us. I love you so much.
You can't kiss her yet. You can't, not yet.
I need you to hold it. Josh, I'm going to make this short and sweet because I have to go to the bathroom. I'll always remember the many times I would see you walking down the hallways of the good old county jail saying, "Dead man walking," when you escorted new inmates with your big, beautiful, and sexy smile. Oh, hold on. It would make me giggle like Phoebe and when Joey says, "How you doing?" Your arms would always be out by your sides, leaving me to wonder if you were capable of reaching the middle of your back. I later learned on that you could not, since you had to use the corners of the walls to scratch your back. Now our son does the same thing. Your daddy does it, okay. Years passed and we went separate ways. We eventually found our way back into each other's lives. It was fate, or maybe it was the tacos, I don't know. We decided to begin our journey together, the unorthodox way. We were blessed with our beautiful son. Life has brought us some rough moments, but you have always been there to guide me through them. You complete me. I love you. I still do not know how a city girl from LA ended up with a country boy who went to the beach with some boots on together. Okay. We are polar opposites, but we balance each other perfectly. You say I drive you crazy. I say you need to separate the whites and the laundry. It's a blessing. I cannot see myself getting old without you or anybody else. Loving you has been the easiest thing ever. I promise to take care of our family, of you, of our growing family, I will promise to continue to drive you nuts. And most importantly, to love you even more. Thank you for this journey with me. I really gotta pee. Te amo.
That's awesome. That's awesome. Wasn't too short, and it was a roast more than a bow. All right, so, but it works. All right. Sweet. Can I get the rings? You know, one of the things I notice about a ring and the significance of a ring is this, is that as you look at it, there's no beginning or end. All right? And so every time you look at this ring, remind yourself that, hey, before God ever created anything, he knew the two of you would be together and live like that and love like that. All right? And you're going to repeat after me here. I forgot the wrong sheet of paper. Josh.
Josh.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my vow.
As a symbol of my vow.
With all that I am.
With all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you.
I honor you.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
The Son.
And the Holy Spirit.
And the Holy Spirit.
Right. Always. And I dropped it.
Okay. Are you nervous?
No. No. Now, the other thing is this about a ring is this, that ring's significant. Were significant back in biblical times, all right? A ring represented, it went to those who had authority. Kings would have them. And one of the things was, is that if you had the king's ring, it meant you had all the authority of the king, all right? Mm-hmm. Now, what I find interesting is also, is in scripture, and this is just a little side note, is that in Ephesians 5 is the first time you ever see women get moved as equals with men, all right? And it was back in Ephesians 5. But to this, when you hand that to her, what you're saying is that all that I am is yours, all right? And the other thing is, it's a great reminder of his love and how he'll always cherish you. So you're going to repeat after me. Joanna. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my vow.
As a symbol of my vow.
With all that I am.
With all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you.
I honor you.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
All right. Well, I just got a couple questions, all right? And then we'll get you guys married, all right?
All right.
So, Josh, you take Joanna to be your wife.
I do.
And Joanna, you take Josh to be your husband.
I do.
All right. Before we kiss, though, all right, since I have the mic and everything, I figured I'd give you guys your wedding gift. Yeah, I got you guys a gift, all right? But here's the thing. When we did premarital counseling, when we talked, we wanted to talk about how Jesus needs to be the foundation. Well, in John 1:1, it says, in the beginning was the Word was with God, and the Word was God. And so I believe the Word is what will guide you and direct you in the right ways. And so the Bible I've been using, I had engraved with y'all's names. And this is the thing I want you guys to read and lean on and encourage each other with.
Absolutely.
Yeah. So. Oh, thank you. Thank you for helping me with the Spanish. All right. I'll take it back and give you later. But. Now that you both said I do, by the power invested in me by the wonderful state of Texas, but more importantly, our Savior, Jesus Christ, it is my honor to pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss your bride. Ladies and gentlemen, for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Torres.
This love that I feel for you always will be. For you're not just time that I'm killing. I'm no longer one of those guys. As sure as I live, this love that I give is gonna be yours until the day that I die. Takes its toll on the body, makes the young girl's brown hair turn gray. Well, honey, I don't care, I ain't in love with your hair. And if it all fell out, well, I'd love you anyway. They say time can play tricks on memory, make people forget things they
Love is everything. It's a whole lot more than going to the store for a wedding ring. It's kissing and a hugging, but it's also the kicking and the cussing thing. I've been told love is everything. It's a smile on your face on a cold winter day at the thought of spring. It's getting up at night for the cry of a little bitty baby thing. And it's growing old. Love is everything. It's those fires that daddy stoked those nights to keep you warm. It's the hell your mama went through the day that you were born. And it's a thunderstorm. Love is everything. Oh, it's going off to war. It's the back and the forth on a front porch swing. It's a kiss that you got in the old parking lot of the Dairy Queen. It's you and me. Love is everything. It's looking out for everybody else but number one. And it's all that really matters when all's said and done and the race is run. Love is everything. It's a rose on a stone. It's the words in the song that the choir sings. It's the tears of goodbye and the place that you fly to get your wings.
For Mr. and Mrs. Torres.
Thank you guys. Hey, to you too, thank you so much. This is an honor to be a part of this. It's incredible, and as we talked about many times, you guys want to have the best marriage ever, all right? It starts today, and then tomorrow we wake up and we look like Christ. And so, you know, here's the thing. What I know is this, is that love is everything. Like you guys picked that song, it's so elegant. You focus on each other and love each other as much as possible, and there's no stopping you, all right? Let me pray for you guys. Father, I thank you so much for this time. Thank you so much for just every person in this room. God, we ask that in the next couple of moments that we celebrate love, we celebrate you, we celebrate marriage. God, we pray right now that you be over the food. God, that you give us energy from this food. God, thank you so much for just the hands that have made it. God, let it remind us that you give good gifts. God, we ask that above all else through this time, that God, we just thank you and keep you focused. But God, also, we thank you so much for Josh and Joanna and the lives that they're about to lead, the parents they are, and the husband and wife they are. Again, God, let them have the best marriage possible. Let love be their foundation, and let them be a couple that people want to imitate. Again, God, we thank you so much for who you are, and it's in Christ's name we pray. Amen.
Thank you.
First of all, I'd like to say thank you, everybody, for coming and sharing this day with us. Very happy to have everybody here. For those of y'all who do not know, Joana is pregnant. So a big portion of today is also finding our gender reveal. So we're going to be cutting into the cake and find out what we're going to be having.
I want to hear you guys if you're for team boy. Okay. Team girl? And la madre. I want to thank you all for joining Joana and Josh on this very special day. Joana, aka Chucky. You are the closest thing to a sister that I have. You were a little terror as a child, hence the nickname Chucky. But we loved you anyway. For those that know, I'm sure will agree that you are one of a kind. You have heart, you have passion, and a hell of a sense of humor. When you left California as a teenager, I was sad, but God knows why he does what he does. You became an amazing young woman, graduated college, and followed your dream of becoming a police officer. I'm sure Corinth and the other agencies you have worked throughout the years had no idea what they were getting when they hired you. As a fellow law enforcement officer, I'm so proud of you. I'll never forget when you told me that you had met Josh. You were dating, and now you were expecting a baby. I thought Rob and I worked fast. So I was so happy for you, and I knew that you would be a great mom to Julian and the baby growing inside of you. Josh, thank you for loving Joana unconditionally and making her happy. I knew it would take an amazing person to love Jo for who she is. You're a great father, and I'm sure you'll make a great husband. If you can love Jo as much as she loves tacos, then you will have a long-lasting and loving marriage. Here's to the beautiful couple. Love you. Cheers.
Me and Josh have been best friends, honestly, a little bit of our lives. He's always been there for me. We've lived together for 21 years. He was always the person I go to for advice, and he was always the person I looked up to. He always had the right answers, and even if he didn't, he tried to show me the best way to get those answers. He was always just that person I can rely on day in, day out. Going through everything that we've had through our entire lives, it just made us stronger. It made us stick together more and more. It is a bond that is unbreakable. Just like the bond that you made with Joe. It's a bond that's not going to break. Because I've seen how much work that you guys put in, day out for each other, for Julian, for everything you guys do. It honestly, it brings hope to me in the future for you guys. I know I don't have to worry about you guys because you guys have each other's backs. And that's how it should be. You know, inviting Joe into our lives, it was a big thing. She's a big personality, I'll tell you that. But honestly, you fit right in with us. You know, laughing, caring, putting family first like it should be. That's what this is all about. We're all a family here. I don't care if you're just friends, you're family here too now. And that's what this is all about, is putting family first. There's one thing that our dad has always taught us growing up, especially when we started dating, was relationships are not 50-50. You can't expect 100% out of 50 from each of you. It takes 100 and 100. You put in everything you got each and every day, and then you have happiness. So, welcome to the family. And bro, I'm proud of you. Cheers.
I'm excited. I'm still processing everything.
Yeah.
But I'm very excited for us to have a baby girl and see Julian as a big brother.
Yes. I can't wait to meet Adeline Lucia Torres. Oh, I hope she looks like me.
I hope she has a little bit more of my temperament, though.
I can't wait to teach her everything we've done with Julian and growing up together and just everything.
Very excited.